when some emergency happens, a new energy is released in your system. We have three layers of energy. First is the energy which you use for your daily activities. Morning 8 o'clock, you start your office work. Evening around 6 o'clock, you are out. After 8, you don't want to do anything, you just want to rest. This is the first day energy which you use for daily activities. There is something called second layer energy. That is what is the emergency layer. Whenever you are in some emergency, this energy releases in your body. Then you can lift any quick stool. I'm going to go for tiger. Dark chases you, then understand. What will happen to your speed? If dog chases you, street dog, your speed? 3-4 times?
More
than normal speed. At the time of emergency, this energy layer releases. That's the second layer energy, emergency layer. The third layer energy is what we call spiritual layer. Through third layer energy only, healing is done, miracles are performed all the time. Miracles, divine powers are expressed only through the third layer energy. Materialization, giving darshan in so many places. All ashtasiddhis belong to third layer energy. Person who has mastered the third layer energy only can give spiritual experiences for us. All spiritual energy belongs to third layer energy. First layer is a day-to-day layer. Second is emergency layer. Third is divine layer. Each one of you are connected to all the three layers of energy. Only thing, we have not used it. We have not explored it. We do not know the technique to explore it. Vishuddhi chakra, the throat center, is the center through which you are connected to all these three layers of energy. That is the gate, the center which we are going to work now. Now we are going to work on the throat chakra. Don't think we are going to work on the root chakra, we are going to work on the throat chakra. It is called Vishuddhi. Shuddhi means purity. Asuddhi means impurity. Vishuddhi means beyond purity and impurity. Understand? Shuddhi means purity. Asuddhi means impurity. Vishuddhi means beyond purity and impurity. This chakra never gets contaminated. This is the door to all three layers of energy. If you work on this chakra, if you open this energy center, all the three energy layers will be available to you. How this chakra gets locked, how this chakra can be opened. Jealousy and comparison locks this chakra. When you compare yourself with others, you make first some boundary for you. Unless you have boundary, can you compare yourself with others? All your boundary is low self-esteem. Understand? All your boundary about yourself, all your idea about yourself is low self-esteem. You are nothing less than God. If you have any other idea about you less than God, be very clear, you have low self-esteem. Whether you believe or not, whether you accept or not, whether you want it or not, you are God. Even if you say, no, no, I am not, I am not, I am not, you are God only. understand one thing. The fish, whether it goes along the current or it goes against the current, it is in the water. Can the fish be anywhere else than water? Whether it goes along with the current or it goes against the current, it is in the water. Whether you have realized or you are not realized, you are in God. If you have realized, you will just float with the current. You will float with the current. If you have not realized, you will swim against the current. Whether you float or swim, you are in the God. Whether you accept or not, whether you want or not, whether you have experienced or not, you are God. All the three layer energies are closely connected to you. You are connected to all these three layer energies. If you are connected to one first layer energy, how can you be disconnected to second layer and third layer? Because they are not separate watertight compartments. It's like you enter into Ganga and then you enter into Ganga Sagar, then into Bay of Bengal. Ganga, Ganga Sagar, Bay of Bengal is not three watertight compartment areas. Same space, three names. Ganga is first layer energy. Ganga Sagar is second layer energy. Bay of Bengal is third layer energy. The problem is some boats, after coming back from the ocean, long time they don't travel in ocean. So they forget ocean belongs to them and they belong to ocean. They start thinking, I can travel only in Ganga. I cannot go in Ganga Sagar. I cannot go in ocean. That is the problem. Because long time you have not traveled inside the ocean, third layer energy, you forgot you belong to third layer energy and third layer energy belongs to you. You have forgotten your true nature. There is a beautiful Advaitic scripture called Swarajya Siddhi, means attaining your own Rajya. Swarajya Siddhi. That's a beautiful book by Atmananda, one great Swami, or Shankara. This Swami has wrote a wonderful commentary on Brahma Sutra. There are five beautiful commentaries on Brahma Sutra. Shankara, Ramanuja, Madhva, Bhamati, then Atmananda. This Atmananda has wrote a beautiful book on his own authority, not commenting on anybody else. His own authority. That book only is called Swarajya Siddhi. Achieving your own kingdom. For a long time, you have not traveled in the ocean. You have not traveled in the third layer energy. That is why you started believing you don't have connection with third layer energy. Leave out third layer, you don't have connection even to the second layer energy. You have forgotten the technique to awaken it. The second layer and third layer energy has become the forgotten language. Now, we are going to work on this third layer energy, on Vishuddhi Chakra. On morning to evening, you have done all meditations. You sat and listened so many things. First layer energy is now over. When you enter into this meditation, next there is a small virtual program, not meditation, just a simple relaxing program. When you do all these things, the second layer energy opens. Tomorrow again you are going to do other meditation techniques. By tomorrow evening the third layer energy will open. The whole program is designed such a way that your first layer energy will be exhausted, second layer energy will be exhausted, and third layer energy will open. you will have at least one glimpse of third layer dimension. You will see your body and mind will totally heal. Disease is nothing but low energy. If the energy is flooded inside your system, naturally all the disease will disappear. It's like a flooding a big river into a small pool. The whole pool will be washed. It will be totally cleansed. That is why the program is designed in such a way that you continuously you are engaged. Let me explain a few words about this jealousy and comparison. You always feel jealous towards the people who has got something more than you. Am I right? Who has got something more than you. If he is more intelligent, you feel jealous. If he has got more wealth, you feel jealous. If he has got more relatives, good friends, you feel jealous. I have seen many people, if the neighbor brings AC, his house temperature will increase. If he brings AC, his house temperature will increase. How that? Jealous. Immediately what they will do? Get monies. If he does something, these people will. When you work, comparing with others, you will end up only in this type of foolish things. We end up only doing this type of foolish things. Look into your own life. How many times you end up doing foolish things comparing with others? Just because your brother is successful in textile industry, you leave your steel business and jump to textile. The moment you jump, you face some difficulty. How long you can stand just because he stands? He must be knowing the technique. You do not know. Then what will happen naturally? Failure. Look into your life. How many times you have taken foolish decisions? How many times you have cut the exhaust pipe compared with that? Look into your life. How many times you have taken the wrong steps in jealousy and comparison? Understand the first thing. When you compare yourself with others, you make boundary for yourself. The very boundary is wrong. Whether you believe or not, whether you accept or not, whether you want it or not, you are God. You are unique, just like everyone else. You are unique. There is no comparison between rose and the lotus. That's a beautiful three words in Vedanta. Ajata, Swaradayata, Swarugabeta means, understand this one example. If you compare between the goat and the cow, it is ajata, two different category. If you compare between the goat's head and the tail, it is swarada. In one animal itself, two parts. If you compare one hair and the other hair of the goat, it is swarupa, inside, more minute. We always think life is a swarupa or swagata, but life is ajata. Ajata means no two person will be born as same. No two person will be born as a same. Between goat and cow, second is in the goat itself, head and tail. Third is in the tail itself, one hair to other hair, white hair and black hair. So broad, then little localized, and little more localized. We always think life is localized. We always think life is very localized. That is why we continuously compare. Life is neither swarupa nor swagata. It is ajata. You cannot compare between goat and cow. Totally two different categories. Both are unique. Same way, you cannot compare yourself with others because you are unique. When you work on this Vishuddhi, if the second layer, third layer energy opens, then you never go for comparing with others. Now, you are going to have beautiful meditation technique, wonderful meditation technique to remove your tiredness and dullness. That is called running. Now you are going to jog. Don't worry. Only when you do, it is done the technical way. I assure you will not feel tired. You will feel only fresh. And after the meditation, you can tell me what you feel. The technique is to open your second layer energy. Let me give you the instruction. First thing, you will concentrate on your Vishuddhi chakra continuously. Second thing, concentrating on Vishuddhi chakra without disturbing the concentration, you will move only your hands. Then you will move only your legs without moving your mind away from Vishuddhi, without disturbing yourself. Slowly you will move your body where you stand. You will be standing in one place, you will be moving your body. And slowly, 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 you will start doing the jogging just for 20 minutes. More than that. Just for 20 minutes. You can start very slowly. You are not asked to run like PT Usha or anything. No. Very slowly. But one thing, slowly, slowly, you should increase the speed. Slowly, slowly increase the speed without diverting your mind from Vishuddhi Chakra. Because concentrating Vishuddhi is only going to open the energies. Whenever you feel tired, your mind says, tired, I am tired. Concentrate on Vishuddhi, you will see that energy is just flooded throughout your system. Third instruction, when your mind says, no, no, I cannot run, this Swami is really torturing us, it is enough, let me run away. When your mind says, I have this pain, that pain, I cannot, enough, simply say no to your mind. I tell you, all these years you believe your mind and live. What you got? Except disease and depression. Nothing is given to you by mind. Now I tell you, believe me just for 20 minutes. And you will understand what I can give you. You will experience what I can give you. Don't believe your mind. Just say no to your mind. Your mind will say, no, just now I've eaten. I cannot run, I will throw out, I will vomit, don't listen to anything. Your mind will say, no, no, I am very giddy, I may fall unconscious. Don't worry, fall, we will take care. Volunteers are here, we will sprinkle water and make you again run. Don't think, just by falling once unconscious, you can escape from meditation. Don't worry, don't bother. Do it, then you will understand. Simply say no to your mind. I am going to do whatever you want to do. You will see within 5 minutes, the second energy takes over your body. You will see very clearly your body is running separately and you are witnessing it separately. You are witnessing your body. As long as you obey your mind, it shows all drama. It does all games on you. Once you say simply flat no to your mind, you will see the secondary energy takes over you and your body will be separately running and you will be seeing it separately. One request, please don't run here and there. Stand in one place, do there itself. Only your movement should be fast. You don't have to run. Pre-instruction, concentrate on Vishuddhi throughout 20 minutes. And after 20 minutes running, 10 minutes you will sit and concentrate on the throat. First. Second thing, slowly, slowly increase the speed. Don't start running in high enthusiasm. Then you will stop, reduce the speed. That's not allowed. Slowly, slowly increase the speed. Third thing, main thing, simply say no to your mind. Any doubt? The instruction? Okay. Please get ready. Mm-hmm.